Welcome back to another team builder for the CPL. This is probably going to be my final team builder for the CPL for this season. Since this is the last battle in the regular season, and I probably won't make playoffs unless for some reason I win in a landslide victory in this battle, and quite a few people lose quite a bit in their battles by a lot, because of my differential, not because of my record. My record is okay, almost going even. If I win this one, it'd be one less than even, which is acceptable by me, since at least two games off the top of my head I can think of that I got hacked out of. But that's just sometimes how it goes in Pokemon. So let us get right into the builder. This week I am going up against Nana, and I am most likely going to lose this match, just because her team just demolishes my team. First off, we have Jirachi, the King of Hacks, and like I said before, I have been hacked a lot in this league this season, and Nada could probably 1v1 me with the Jirachi just hacking me out, just spamming that Iron Head or Heart Stamp. Then we have the Zapdos, nice and bulky. Deals well against my Bulu and decently walls Cabellon. Can deal with Dolmise, and is a great answer to Galvantula because it has debug to get rid of it, my webs, and it basically can take any hit from Galvantula quite well. So definitely going to see that as a bulky pivot. Most likely with Defog, Roost, Volt Switch, and then some fourth move, most likely. Then we have Infernape, which can demolish my team, with like Flare Blitz, Close Comet, and then either Thunder Punch or Stone Edge. This is all the three moves that she needs to demolish my team. It is one of her Z captains, the other one being Jirachi and Rabambi. Only thing it doesn't straight up demolish with its dab is like the Gyarados, and like I said before, it just needs like Thunder Punch or Stone Edge to take care of that. And then we have Blastoise, my Wenchu counter in draft format. Decently walls the Gyarados and Megazord X. That's main reason she would probably bring it, as well as Rapid Spin if she is bringing hazard support, like webs on that Rabami. And of course the Scald, basically 100% guaranteed burn on my mons. Since it is going to be coming from Blastoise, which, like I said, my Wenchu counter and draft. Then we have Skunk Tank. Skunk Tank is grounded poison, so would help deal with Toxic Spikes on my end if I decide to bring them with Garbodor, as well as Poison and Dark are nice, as well as that Priority Sucker Punch to deal with things on my end, such as the Gyarados and the Megazord X. If I set up, Sucker Punch would be nice for that. Skunk Tank is where we're starting to get into mods that are interchangeable, more likely. Top 3 definitely coming, Blastoise definitely coming. Rabambi would be brought mainly, or basically just for webs, to help Infernape and Jirachi sweep up this game, as well as because that helps deal with scarfers that would like to deal with Infernape for my team, as well as counterwebs my team. So webs for webs would just mean everything is if there was no webs. And then we have Zangoose. Zangoose is fast, and with that toxic boost, facade basically demolishes everything. Things it doesn't demolish with facade, it can hit with a fighting move to demolish, and yeah, quite threatening. Then we have Magnezone. Magnezone would be nice for pivot momentum, with the Zapdos, with the Infernape, with the Jirachi, with U-turn and Volt Switch, just pivoting around. However, it would give her another steel type on our team, which means that my Zard X could run rampant with Flare Blitz, and its trapping potential with Magnet Pole isn't useful since Cobalion can blow it back with a fighting move. And yeah, next up we have Florges. Florges would be brought as a cleric. If she is going for a bulkier team, definitely would want to bring the Florges over something like that Rock Bombi or Skuntank. Definitely not going to see both Rock Bombi and Florges, because both fairies, even though my poison type is Garborder and doesn't really have the best matchup, and my Cobalion and Steel, and sort of struggles as well, wouldn't want to risk that, as well as Floor just invites setup on my part, and I don't think she wants that happening. The less setup I get, the more or easy it is for her to deal with me. Then we have Mega Sceptile. Mega Sceptile outspeeds my entire team. However, if it's not running something like Iron Tail or like a hidden power to hit Tapu Fulu, it kind of struggles to deal with that Fulu, as well as other things on my team, such as Gyarados, because it would need like HP Electric to deal with the Gyarados. Then it wouldn't have an HP to hit hidden power to hit Tapu Fulu. And yeah. Could though be brought to try and take advantage of that grassy terrain, as well as Dragon Pulse is actually quite nice for my Zardex. Then we have Diggersby. Diggersby against my team is basically just another Zangoose, except slower, because I do have that Bulu deters the Earthquake, which is the advantage over the Zangoose, basically. That and elemental punches, and yeah, as well as momentum with U-turn if she really wants it. And then last but not least, we have Rhydon. Definitely not being brought. Struggles against my team, struggles against Bulu, even against Tyranitar. Gyarados blows it back, Cobalion blows it back, and Delmize blows it back, Claydol blows it back, Glaceon blows it back, Zardex it's about neutral. Covantula can blow it back with a grass move. Garbordo, if it's not running Seed Bomb, loses to it, against itself, about even, and then Meloetta can blow it back in both forms. So let us get into my team. First off, we have Godzilla, the Tyranitar, Focus S, Sandstream, Earthquake, Stone Edge, Dragon Dance, Crunch. Definitely leading with this no matter what. Get off that Dragon Dance right off the start. Hopefully it doesn't lead with like Jirachi and Iron Head flinches me. Because then I can basically sweep through her entire team, except for the Blastoise and Mega Sceptile. And yeah. Enough speed to outspeed Infernape after plus one. Max attack. And the rest into HP. Next up, I am bringing Ditto, Joy Scarf, Silly Putty, Transform. That is IVs for Hidden Power Ground, in case she brings like Magnet Zone with Hidden Power. Can catch that off guard and blow it back with an HP Ground myself. HP Ground is quite nice against quite a few of her teams, such as the Infernape, the Skunk Tank, or two Steel types, and that. Right on, if I need it. And yeah, hopefully I can get something like that Infernape, or maybe even the Jirachi to win this game. I would need Jirachi weakened though before I get it. Unless it's running something like Shadow Ball to deal with itself, or yeah. Have been using Ditto quite well this season, and hopefully it can put it into work in this game as well. Next up, I am bringing, let's go with Cabalion. Cabalion, bringing a Calm Mindset this time. Speed Ties, Infernape. If I'm remembering correctly, like a standard Stealth Wreck Jirachi after plus one gets blown back by Team Z. Flash Cannon, Focus Blast, Hidden Power Ice basically blows everything back. At plus three, it guarantees Oko's every single mon on our team. And things it doesn't like blow back at plus two can easily, or plus one can get blown back by a Vitinium Z. Basically outspeeds a good chunk of her team that I needed to. Justified boost is nice if goes for a brings that Skunk Take for a dark move. Next up we have Tapu Bulu, Undergrowth, Leftovers, Grassy Surge, Rock Tomb, Leech Seed, Hornleys, Nature of Madness, and I'm at 252 HP, 130 attack, or 64 attack, 60 speed def, and 132 speed. So this is a lot of different investments. The speed at 132 is enough to outspeed her base 100s after a Rock Tomb. Enough attack to be able to take out standard Violite Rhydon with the Hornleech, max HP, and then the remaining 16 Dispel Death. This allows me to take on a take two hits from a defensive Zapdos with that max HP and 60 Dispel Death. Heat Wave from a defensive Zapdos, no special attack. Is not too shotting me, which is nice, and I can get the Leech Seed off onto it and get that Nature Madness off. Nature Madness is going to be a big part of this match if she does not bring that. Florges. And yeah. You already saw Davey the Delmice, Joyce Band, Steelwork, Rabbit's Pin, Switcheroo, Anchor Shot, Shadow Claw. Enough attack to knock out Jirachi in one shot, or max HP Jirachi in one shot with Shadow Claw. Anchor Shot should be able to, I'm pretty sure, also knocks out Florges in one shot, even if it's max HP, max defense. defense boost in nature. Rerouted spin to get rid of hazards, such as the webs and off or Bombi and rocks off of Jirachi, most likely. Don't need to run Grass Stab on here because I do have that Bulu with the Horn Leech. And Switcheroo is nice to possibly trick this Choice Band onto like the Zapdos or something else, like maybe the Forgest. And make them less of a threat. With this, also with this HP and speed def, same as Boogaloo not getting too shot by Heatwave from defensive Zapdos, which is real nice. And last but not least, we have Dreidel, the Clay Doll, Wiki Berry, Levitate, Earth Power, Ice Beam, Ancient Power, and Calm Mind. If she does bring Orbombi, hopefully I can get Ditto in on it and get webs from that. Slow down things so that Clay Doll can put in the work, even though its speed actually doesn't actually allow it to outspeed the base 100s and above. But can basically take hits quite well from things, and hopefully I can get the Ancient Power boost. The hacks will work in my favor for once. Hoping that since I've had such terrible luck so far, I'm due for a good amount of luck. But basically, Earth Power, Ice Beam, Ancient Power, it's almost everything for super effective. If not, at least at plus two, I believe I one-shot everything except maybe the Zapdos. But the Zapdos can't really do anything back to me. Hopefully I can win this game and pray that for some reason I make it to playoffs. But I am totally fine if I don't make it to playoffs. So catch you for the battle, as I hopefully take my revenge on Nana for the WCBL match. So, bye-bye!